Hello everyone. Today we are going to learn how to use the eCourts app. This app can be used to track the status of your court cases in India. You can download this app on your iOS or Android devices from the App Store or Play Store respectively. This app has been made and maintained by the government itself. Open the app and this is the screen that will be shown. On the top left hand corner, there are various options. I'll come to CNR case status, cause list and my cases later. First, you can choose configure. Here by default, the district court case statuses will be shown. So you can choose either high court, district court or both. I'm going to choose both. As you can see at the top, the district court and the high court is shown. You can toggle between the two. Right now, I'm going to stick to district court. There's also the ePay, the NJDG option. ePay takes you to an external link where you can pay your court fee, you can pay your judicial deposit, you can pay a fine or a penalty. Coming back to the eCourts app, the NJDG stands for the National Judicial Data Grid. Here it shows the entire status of all the pending cases across courts in India. That is the district courts and the high courts. Coming back to the eCourts app, number one is the option of CNR. This is a unique 16-digit code that is given to every case. You can search your case by the CNR number or you can go to the case status. Here you can see that you can find your case using the case number, the party details, filing number, FIR number, advocate's name, which act is referred to for your case, the case type or the caveat. I'm going to select the state first, that is Maharashtra. Then I have to select the district. I'm going to select the Mumbai Chief Metropolitan Magistrate's Court. I'm going to search my case using case number. I have to select the court complex, the case type, the case number, and the year. All these details you'll find in any of the pleadings. As you can see, the case is now shown. I'm going to select it. These are the details of the case. I'll first just add the case. On the top right hand side, you can see add case. I go back. And now I'm going to go to my cases. As you can see, the case is now shown here. I'm going to select this case and take you through what I can see. I can find all the details of the case, the date of the first hearing, the next hearing date, what stage it is at, which court and the judge. There's a QR code given to every case. You can find the details of the petitioner and the advocate, the respondent and the advocate. You can see which acts are hit by this case. And the most important thing is the history of case hearing. As you can see, every date that has been given in this particular case is recorded over here. You can see all the different case dates. A very interesting thing is once you click on the date, this 28th Feb, for example, it will take you to what happened on that particular day. This has to be recorded on every date. This is really useful to know what stage your case is at and what is expected on the next date of hearing. I'm going back now. You can do the similar thing for any of your high court cases as well. There are a few high courts which have not yet been onboarded on this app. You can also see your cause list. You can choose your state first, choose your district. You select which case your court, which court your case is in. So I'm just going to select a random one and I'm going to see the cause list for today on the civil side. Unfortunately, this does not have one, but here you can see which serial number your case is going to come at. I hope you find this video useful. In case there is anything else you would like to know, you can write in the comment section below and I'll be happy to address all your queries. This video has been made by Presolve 360, which is a platform that helps you resolve your disputes in a manner that is faster, better and cost effective. Log on to our website to know more. The website link is in the description below.